Good afternoon, everyone. Today we will see the topic antenna basics. Myself, Piyusha Shetgar. These are the learning outcomes for this session. At the end of this session, students will be able to analyze the electric and magnetic field emission from various basic antennas, and they will be able to explain basic principle of radiation and list different applications of antennas. These are the contents for this session. Now, see the antenna basics. Antennas are nothing but the connecting link between the transmitter, free space and receiver, and it is also considered as the basic component of any electric system. It is an electric device which converts electric power into radio waves or radio waves into electric power. Thus, antenna can be used to convert one form of energy into other form. In the world, antenna are like our electronic eyes and ears. They are our links with the space. Antennas used with a radio transmitter or radio receiver. Antennas plays an important role in our civilization. Now, before going to start the antennas in details, you can pause video here for 2 seconds and recall that what is meant by electromagnetic waves. Antennas are related to the EM waves, therefore recall here what is electromagnetic waves. Yes, the electromagnetic waves are nothing but it is the combination of electric field and the magnetic field. These two fields are perpendicular to each other, and the electric field and the magnetic fields are perpendicular to each other, and also they are traveling into the particular direction, x direction, y direction or z direction. So these type of waves includes radio waves, microwaves, infrared, etc. Light, ultraviolet, x-rays and gamma rays. Now, the electromagnetic waves. In EM waves, the electric field and the magnetic fields are perpendicular to each other. Thus, in this figure, the red wave shows the magnetic field and the blue wave shows by the electric field. As you know that the electric field and the magnetic fields are perpendicular to each other, and the wave is traveled in the direction of the propagation of the wave. Here, in this example, the wave is traveling in x direction. Again, you can see that the electromagnetic waves which having the electric field intensity and the magnetic field intensity, these two fields are varying fields, and the wave is also perpendicular to the direction of the propagation of the wave, and the distance between the two successive crest or trough is known as the wavelength. Now, the electromagnetic waves can be defined in two ways, guided waves and unguided waves. The guided waves defined by cables, waveguides and quasi-optical system. This type of transmission line used at the different frequencies, such as cables are used at frequencies below 35 GHz, waveguides used between 0.4 GHz to 350 GHz, whereas quasi-optical system used above 30 GHz. Now, what is the meaning of these guided electromagnetic waves? As you know that the transverse electromagnetic waves cannot support to the waveguide. That is, TM waves travel in cables and the quasi-optical system, which is same as nothing but free space. While TM and TE waves, or the combination of both these waves, can be traveled through the waveguide. Here, in waveguide, the electric or magnetic field components are in the direction of the propagation of the wave. EM wave becomes, it bounces back and forth on the inner walls of the waveguide, which having the different frequency limits. You can define these different frequency limits with the lower and the upper frequency limit, whereas the cross section dimension of this type of a wave proportional to the wavelength. Now, this is a diagram shows the guided wave to free space transition. Here, the transmitting antenna is connected to the generator side, or it is also known as the transmitter side. From this, the electromagnetic wave is generated, which is traveling through this transmission line such as the waveguide, and again it takes the transition in tapered form, and it goes to the free space, that is in antenna. Thus the antenna provides the vital element. It plays an important role in wireless technology, and therefore the vital element of the wireless technology is nothing but the antenna. Now the basic elements of the antenna. Now consider the current carrying conductor is placed and the electrons are flowing through this conductor. When this movement of the electrons is occur, it creates the two fields. These fields dealing with the time and space quadrature from the antenna. This field produces a radiating wave pattern. We can represent these radiations by the vectors, and the wave associated with this vector is traveling wave pattern. So here you can observe that this wave having the electric field as well as the magnetic field, and these two fields are varying with time phase and the space quadrature, and the polarity of the antenna determined by plane of the electric field. Here the electric field and magnetic field perpendicular to each other and also perpendicular to the direction of the propagation of the wave. Again you can see that these are the field variation with the current direction. As you know that the field variation is occur when the current carrying conductor is placed and the electrons are flowing through this conductor. When the flux linked to this conductor changes, the current start to flow through this conductor. So here the direction of the electric field is from positive to negative, and thus the current direction is in upward direction. So here the field variation is considered with the direction of the current. Now the antenna can be used either as a transmitting antenna or as a receiving antenna, and therefore the antenna is also called as the duplexer. In two-way communication, the same antenna can be used as a transmitter or the receiver. Now what is the transmitting antenna? At the transmitting antenna, the generator is connected. It converts electrical signal into the electromagnetic waves and it radiates them into the free space. And now this transmission line is connected to the source or generator. This line energy is guided as plane transverse electromagnetic wave with a very little loss is considered. And the spacing between the line is having a very small fraction of the wavelength, which is denoted with the letter lambda. As this line is opened out in free space, it acts like an antenna which launches in a free space wave, since the currents on the transmission line is flow out, but the fields associated with them is keep going on. Antennas appear to the transmission line as a resistance, and therefore it is called as a radiation resistance, denoted with the RR. Now the receiving antenna. At the receiver side, the electromagnetic waves converts into the electrical signal. In the reception side, an antenna intercepts some of the power of the radio waves in order to produce an electric current at its terminal, whereas this signal is amplified at the receiver side. Antennas are essential components of all radio equipment. So here it is the example of the figure with the transmitter antenna and the receiver antenna. The same antenna can be used as a transmitter as well as the receiver. So in transmitter, the generator can be connected to this transmitting antenna. Here the electromagnetic signals are generated, which are traveling through the transmission line. We can consider it as a waveguide. It opened out and it acts as an antenna. Again, from this free space, the signal is coming towards the receiver side, and at the receiver side, this signal is amplified. Antenna can also be termed as an aerial. The plural of it is known as the antennae or antennas. Nowadays, antennas have undergone many changes in accordance with their size and shape. So there are the many types of the antennas can be used, depend on the number of applications. So what are the applications of the antennas? Antennas are essential components of all equipment that uses radio. They are used in systems such as radio broadcasting, broadcast television, two-way radio communication, receivers, etc. radar, cell phones and satellite communication, other devices such as garage door opener, wireless microphones, wireless computer networks and RFID tags, etc. Now, what is the principle of the antenna? Under time varying condition, the Maxwell equations predict the radiation of electromagnetic energy from current source, that is, it is related to the accelerated charge. This happens at all frequencies, but is significant as long as the size of the source region is not comparable to the wavelength. While the transmission lines are designed to minimize this radiation loss, radiation into the free space becomes the main purpose in case of the antenna. The basic principle of the antenna is produced by the accelerated charge. For that, consider this is the equation. The basic equation for the principle of the radiation is I dot L equal to Q V dot, whereas I dot is the time changing current in ampere per second and the V dot is the time changing velocity. The time changing velocity is nothing but the acceleration. Thus, the time changing current radiates and the accelerated charge also radiates. For the steady state harmonic variation, usually we focus on time changing current, and for transient usually we focus on the accelerated charge. Whereas this radiated power is proportional to the square of the I dot L or Q V dot. Now this is the figure shows the principle of the antenna, whereas this is considered as with respect to the time changing current and the accelerated charge. Now while designing the antenna, the following factors are to be considered: the strength of the radiated field in different directions, the total power radiated is compared with the driving power of the antenna, consider the impedance of the antenna and the frequency range for that particular antenna, that is, it is also known as the bandwidth. Now these are the types of the antennas, mainly the three types of the antennas: isotropic antenna, directional antenna and the omnidirectional antenna. So what is isotropic antenna? In this type of the antenna, the signal radiates uniformly in all direction and generally it is also used as a reference antenna. In directional antenna, the signal radiates maximum signal in only one direction as a major lobe and the minimum in other direction as a minor lobe. Whereas in omnidirectional antenna, it radiates signal in only one direction, maybe the x-axis, y-axis or the z-axis, and the no back lobe is present in case of the omnidirectional antenna. So these are the basic types of the antennas. That is, the antennas can be divided into various types depending on the physical structure of the antenna, frequency range of the antenna and the mode of application of the antenna. So the physical structure is considered for the following types of the antennas: wire antennas, aperture antennas, reflector antennas, lanes, microstrip and the array antennas. Whereas the frequency can be defined with the different ranges of the frequency, such as the very low frequency, medium frequency, very high frequency, ultra high frequency, super high frequency, microwave, radio waves, etc. And the mode of the operation, the types of antennas according to the mode of the applications: point-to-point communication, broadcasting applications, radar communications, satellite communication, etc. Now, in the antenna theory, which follows the reciprocity theorem, during transmission or reception, an antenna exhibits the identical impedance, same directional pattern, same effective height. Thus, the transmission and the reception antenna can be used interchangeably because it having the all these characteristics are same. The medium must be linear, passive and the isotropic. Now this is the, although the antenna can be used as a both transmitting antenna and the receiving antenna, the properties of the antenna being unchangeable, it is known as the reciprocity theorem. These properties are nothing but the equality in directional patterns, equality in directivities, effective lanes and the equality in the antenna impedances. These are the references for this session. Thank you.